We've got triangles, but these are special triangles. They're called hero triangles. You're like that. Heronian triangles. And these are particular types of hero triangles. A hero triangle is a triangle that has integer sides, whole number sides, and an integer area. Okay, so it's just something that mathematicians like to play with. You should think of these a lot like perfect numbers and things like that. It's just something that mathematicians like to have fun with. We've played with these for a long time. Even now, we're still coming up with new things about them. But these are particularly special.
They're superhero triangles.
These are our superhero triangles, absolutely. I've now given you permission to put clickbait thumbnails on this video. Get a Captain America over here. Oh, can't believe it, superhero triangles. So my first one, it's a right angle triangle. So the idea is they've got integer sides, and so this has sides 5, 12, and 13, which is called a Pythagorean triangle as well, Pythagorean triple. But this is what I wanted to point out. Look at the perimeter. The perimeter is adding up the three sides, and so I reckon the perimeter is 30. So 12 plus 13 plus 5. And the area, if you work out the area, well, it's half the base times the height, if you remember the formula for an area of a triangle, which will be 30 as well. So they've got the same perimeter, they've got the same area. That's what these five triangles have in common. So if I do my next one, you can see this one's a right angle triangle as well. Perimeter is 24, area is 24. And let's have a look at these next three. This one, perimeter. What is the perimeter? 36. And you won't be surprised, area is 36 as well.
These ones aren't right angles, are they, Lisa?
So these last three I'm drawing out are not right angle triangles. Yes. If we look at the perimeter, perimeter 42, area 42, everyone's favourite. And the last one, this really long one then. So the perimeter is 60, area is 60, right. They do remind me of perfect numbers. The way that they kind of refer back to itself, a perfect number is when you look at the factors of the number and it adds up to itself, and it reminds me of that. So the perimeter and the area are the same. And even though there are an infinity of possible triangles we could have with integer sides, integer areas, these are the only five that have the same perimeter and the same area. So there is five and five only.
Presumably you can upsize these same five.
That is a good point, but the problem with that is if we took, say, this triangle, if we double it, then we would double the perimeter and the area gets multiplied by four. So when you double the perimeter, area is multiplied by four. So even including scaled up versions of triangles, this is the five. The only five we can find. So let me give you some facts about this. These things go back thousands of years. It's just one of those things mathematicians study. So these are facts about the Heronian triangles, which means they have integer sides and integer area. So they are named after a mathematician from way back, 2000 years ago, Hero of Alexandria. They're not that hard to find. We saw that we can do it with a Pythagorean triangle, Pythagorean triples. That's a well-known thing. And there are infinitely many of these, and they're quite easy to make. I mean, the simplest is the 3-4-5 triangle. Perimeter, 12. And the area, half the base times the height, is 6. So you can do this, but any Pythagorean triangle would work. As another example, 17, 15, 8 would work as well. So it's got an integer perimeter, which I think is 40, and the area is a integer as well, 60. That's going to be guaranteed to be an integer.
So they're heroes, but not superheroes.
That's right. Guaranteed, every Pythagorean triangle is going to have this property, because you're going to have an integer perimeter, and yes, you're guaranteed to have integer area as well. And what I mean is, you're guaranteed, because it's half the base times the height, it means you are guaranteed that one of these sides is an even number. So out of all those infinite Pythagorean triangles, only two of them have this property where the area is the same as the perimeter. And then the other three are not right-angled triangles. So what else could we have? So I can tell you straight away, if you wanted an equilateral triangle like this, with sides all the same length, whatever that is, I'm afraid that's never going to have an integer area. So you can't do it with equilateral triangles. They don't exist. What else could we do? What about an isosceles triangle? Yes, we can do that. I'll show you an example. A 5, a 5, and a 6. Perimeter is 16, and the area is going to be 12. So we've got integer perimeter, integer area. It's a bit of a cheat, though. I don't know if you noticed it was a bit of a cheat, because if I drop a vertical line here, what it is, it's actually two right-angle triangles stuck together. It's actually a 5, 4, 3 right-angle triangle stuck together. So I'm afraid, yes, you can do isosceles triangles, although they are a bit of a cheat. So can we make triangles that are not a bit of a cheat? Okay, so we'll go a bit more general now. Here's another triangle. It's going to be a 15, a 20, and a 25. So, what's it going to be? Perimeter is 60. Area is 150. So this works. This is one of our hero triangles, but I've cheated again because you can drop a vertical line, you can split it into two right angle triangles. So the question is, are they all cheats? Are there any triangles that aren't just made out of Pythagorean right angle triangles? So you can do triangles that aren't cheats. Here is a 5, 29, and 30. So here's a triangle with a perimeter of 64 and an area of 72. And that cannot be broken up into two right angle triangles that are Pythagorean. If you drop a vertical line here, well, we know what? It's half the base times the height. We're trying to work out the height now. So area is half base times height. I'm trying to work out the height. So the height is going to be, well, twice the area divided by my base, which is 144 divided by 30, but it's not an integer, which means it's not going to be a right angle triangle with integer side. When you get these are called the indecomposable ones. They're ones that you can't break up. You can break them up into right angle triangles, and they're going to be rational sided right angle triangles, but not always integer ones. So these are like indecomposable. So why are these called hero triangles, named after Hero of Alexandria, who, mathematician, 2,000 years ago, worked in the library of Alexandria, like this big famous thing. And there is a formula for the area of a triangle that is credited to Hero of Alexandria, which I wasn't taught at school, and I wish I was. I was taught area of a triangle is half the base times the height. And I've always used that. And sometimes the height is difficult to work out, and you have to use a bit of Pythagoras' theorem, work out the height, and then you can do half the base times the height. Well, here's a formula where we don't need to know the height of your triangle. The area of this triangle is going to use A, B, and C. Lovely. Now the perimeter is A plus B plus C. I'm going to use something called a semi-perimeter, which you might be able to guess is half the perimeter. And we're going to use that in the formula for area. The area of this triangle is the semi-perimeter multiplied by semi-perimeter minus A, side A, multiplied by semi-perimeter minus B, multiplied by semi-perimeter minus C, and the final thing is all square rooted. So if I wanted to work out my previous example, which was a 5, 29, 30, and I don't want to work out the height, then I can use this formula. It's going to be half the perimeter multiplied by 32 minus, let's do side A's 5, so that's going to be 27, multiplied by 32 minus 29, which is just an easy 3, minus 32 minus 30, which is just a 2, that is going to be square rooted. So you can work it out, okay? You multiply this out, it is 72.
Not bad.
It's a lovely formula, isn't it? You get the formula by Pythagoras' theorem. Use Pythagoras' theorem over and over again, rewrite it in terms of A, B, and C, but it turns out really neat. You get this lovely neat formula without having to work out the height of the triangle. But we were interested in triangles that have the same perimeter and the same area.
The superheroes.
These are the superheroes. We've got a formula for area. So let's do it. Right, we've got area is this. We want it to be the same as 2s, that's the perimeter, is equal to area. which is the square root thing. All right, oh, well, let's just tidy it up. You know, square both sides, 4s squared is this stuff. And then we can divide by s. We've got s on both sides, so we get 4s equals s minus a, s minus b, s minus c, little formula. And I might not go through the whole thing, but you can do this. I recommend if you want to solve this now and find those triangles, let's call these three terms x, y, and z. The left-hand side, 4 times s will become 4 times x plus y plus z. So, oh, let's say x is less than y, less than z. Let's put them in order, and there's no reason why it shouldn't be in that order. Yeah, it doesn't take that much to work out. Actually, let's do it. You do x equals 1, stick that into this, solve it. If you solve that, you will find three solutions. And the three solutions are these triangles, the funny triangles here. If you have x equals 2, you get your two right angle triangles. If x equals 3, you get no new solutions. And if you're looking at bigger numbers, you'll find it's impossible. If you look at this equation here, on the left-hand side, x is the smallest number. X is smaller than y, it's smaller than z. The left-hand side, which is this, will be smaller than 4 lots of z plus z plus z. Z is the biggest number out of those three, which is 12z. And on the right-hand side, x, y, z, it's going to be bigger than, x is bigger than 4, so we can say it's bigger than 4, y is bigger than 4 as well, so it's bigger than 4 times 4 times, let's have z here, because that will be 16z. And to solve it, we're looking for a number smaller than 12z, bigger than 16z at the same time, which is impossible, which means you can stop looking, end of proof. So there's only a few things you have to check, and you find all the possibilities. So we found 5 triangles where the perimeter is the same as the area, which is kind of, you know, cute, right? And you can see that they're kind of like perfect numbers. Here's another triangle I wanted to show you. Let's draw it out. This has 33, 34, and 65. And for that, it's a perimeter of, if I'm all correct, 132, and an area, well, we have a formula for that now, but I'll tell you the area, 264. So this is a triangle where the area is double the perimeter. Well, I can tell you there are 18 of those. And I can tell you, if you want your area to be some multiple of the perimeter, it's always a finite number. So it's always these lovely little finite lists. So if you want it to be equal to the perimeter, we have our list of 5. If we want it to be double the perimeter, we now have this list of 18, and same for triple and times it by 4 and so on. So I've got some news. Even though these triangles have been studied for thousands of years, we're still learning new things about them. And we've discovered some new hero triangles. So I've printed them out here.
New heroes.
Yeah, they're kind of interesting. You can see the point where my printer ran out of ink. Some of these triangles come in pairs. Before I talk about these special ones, I'll do an example of a pair of triangles.
Your triangles are getting worse. Look at those two. They're terrible.
They're great triangles. These really valid, lovely drawn triangles, 21, 20 and 29, and we've got a 17, a 28 here, and a 25. And if you look at the perimeters and areas, because that's what we're doing, the perimeter of the first one is 70, the area is 210. Oh, so that would be on our list of triple. The area is triple the perimeter. This one, perimeter of 70, area of 210. Like sometimes when we're studying numbers come in pairs sometimes. These triangles have come in pairs because they have the same perimeter, same area, different triangles, but they have this in common. So there's infinitely many of these pairs if you want to go looking for them, but this one is special. And this pair is special and unique because it is the only pair that has a right angle triangle and an isosceles triangle with the same perimeter, same area. This was proven to be the only pair in 2018. So really recently, even though this stuff goes back thousands of years, This has only just been shown to be this unique pair of triangles. You can find these triangles without too much difficulty, but proving that they're the only possible pair like this was quite difficult. So I said there were no equilateral hero triangles. It's just impossible. So you've got nice equilateral triangle, all got the same side. I'm afraid your area is always going to have some sort of root. It's always going to be some irrational number. It's horrible. But there are some near misses. And so there are a few examples of this, but I like this one in particular, 13, 14, 15. So they're just either side of 14. If you take 14 as the middle number, one below, one above, and that not an equilateral triangle, perimeter of 42 and an area of, 84, which also means it's one of our double area on the list. Just misses being an equilateral. Also, there are examples of this that are bigger, where it's just the three consecutive numbers, and the bigger it is, the more it looks like an equilateral triangle as well.
We've got some superhero triangle merchandise like t-shirts and cups and things just because, well, because it's good fun. It's a good talking point and also it's a way for you to support Numberphile. Check out the links on screen and down in the description. Thanks for watching. We'll be back again soon.
This is true as well if the circle happens to overlap. We definitely still get a circle. This point, if this is A, this will invert to a point there. This is touching this circle.